Hey, this is Angus McFife.
And I am the Hootsman.
We're both with Gloryhammer, and we're going to answer 10 questions of Metal Injection.
What is the story behind the album title, Legends from Beyond the Galactic Terror Vortex?
I think it's just a stupid idea of Chris.
It's a description of the album.
Yeah, and I think he was just searching for a title that's as long as possible, so nobody can remember it.
What is your favorite song from the album, and why?
Well, actually, I think it's the Hoots Force. I know you're gonna disagree with me.
Really, that's your favorite song?
I think it's the most commercial song on the album. That's why I like it.
I think mine ended up being Power of the Laser Dragonfire, I think, maybe. Because I like the melody of the chorus, and there's like this weird little keyboard thing in the middle of the pre-chorus that I really like.
Can you tell us about the worst show Gloryhammer has ever played?
The worst show? It must have been, I think, Dubbo in Australia. Or it could also have been, what was it called?
Elements of Rock?
Bilston.
Oh, right. You're picking, yeah, fair enough. Oh, yeah, fuck me, right, Bilston.
Yeah, that was our first ever tour.
And, I think you're picking on Dubbo too much, because although like it was a really stupid show, it was funny to actually do it.
It was pretty funny, especially because I couldn't sing back then.
Oh, yeah.
So I had a problem with my voice there.
Chris,
I was sick.
Vocals.
And Chris, yeah, he did the vocals for me for our Salentaries of the Frozen Princess. And that was quite funny for me to watch, actually.
If you woke up as your personal hero, who would you be and what would you do?
For me personally, I'd say it would be Link of the Legend of Zelda, because he was the big inspiration for my costume. And I'd probably go to Princess Zelda if I could, no?
I'd probably be Indiana Jones.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just go around beating shit out of people, beating shit out of Nazis, cracking a whip.
If Gloryhammer collaborated with a pop artist, who would that be?
Justin Bieber? I don't know.
You're going to team up with Justin Bieber? Why?
Probably because it would make loads of money, I guess. It's just having his name on it. All his like Bieber fans would buy it. I'd probably, to be fair, if it was like there was money in it, I'd probably do it with anyone.
What is the greatest story ever told?
I think the story of our new album is quite cool, especially if you also listen to the first two albums. It's so complicated that even myself, I can't really remember what we're on, actually.
No, I don't read the booklets or the lyrics.
Does Gloryhammer usually start with writing concept or music?
I'd say usually there's some ideas for the concept, at least in the beginning, but they're getting thrown over for like at least 10 times until the project is finished.
Like the concept for this album comes from the end of the last one, where like at the end of the last album, Explosion, Portal, you go through the portal. So it has to start, this one started like that, and then went on from there.
And we had some cool ideas, like a laser shooting dinosaur.
Do you share any similarities with your characters in the story?
Especially you do, I guess.
Yeah, I drink a lot and shout and hoot around.
Yeah, I'm the good guy, so I guess, yeah. And then we have evil sorcerer.
Mike's a cunt.
That's right. And we have Ben, our hermit, who sleeps under tables and on toilets.
Do you prefer making music videos or performing live?
Personally, I think for me, it's performing live, because there's a connection between me and the audience, and I really like that feeling, that energy of the audience, especially when they're fully into our music and they know how to sing along. That's pretty cool. Sometimes I forget lyrics, you know, and then I just look into the audience and then, now I know again. And that's a really cool experience, especially also at festivals where there's tens of thousands of people, like at Wacken, for example. Looking forward to that one. This year we're playing Wacken on the main stage, and it will be quite an experience, I guess.
Gloryhammer is almost 10 years old. What do you foresee in the next 10 years of the band?
The next 10 years? No. Oof, I don't want to know, guys.
The album keeps taking longer and longer to get out. So if we go by this one, maybe there'll be another album, one more album out within the next 10 years?
Yeah, at least. But I don't want to know, because when I look back at how we looked in the first video and then compare it to now, I think, you know, I don't want to know.
I looked like a lot younger and healthier. Yeah. You had crazy hair.
I had a lot of long hair.
Yeah. I'll probably be bald in 10 years, maybe. Maybe I'll be dead.
Nobody knows. But yeah, we'll find out. And you'll find out. To be honest, I'm looking forward to the next 10 years, even if we'll look like shit in 10 years, because I think Gloryhammer is on a good way up. Thank you very much for watching the 10 questions, and pick up our new record, Legends from Beyond the Galactic Terror Vortex.